Dear Marcus. Oh, Marcus, I know it has been years, and I haven't seen you. You're your family, and for that, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for not replying to your letters all these years, but this is urgent. I know you, Marcus. I know how you think of me, and you know I'm not a lunatic. Father called me a lunatic, that drunk son of a bitch, but I'm not. This is not a case of delusion, and I'm not losing my grasp again, so just please believe my words. 3 days ago, I was outside gathering some firewood, and suddenly I notice a light flickering inside Gary's house. This lone, yellow light calling from the corner of my eye. There's something about that light, I swear. I watch it and it seems to. Then, Marcus, it strikes me. This odd sensation that something powerful is staring back at me from Gary's windows. And you remember Gary Jorgensen, that little neighbor of mine? Well, Gary Jorgensen is gone. He left his house that morning. So what? He's watching me from his empty house. Dear Marcus, I've moved my desk and bed closer to the window so I can keep an eye on this conscious house. Yesterday night, I saw shadows moving inside the house. That house with its skin rotting off, you know, its bare bones sticking out. And yes, I'm aware that I sound like a madman to you, Marcus, but have you forgotten what this suffocating cold can do to you? The way these blizzards can shake the house and make their way through the gaps. And living next to Gary? Oh, how glad I am he's gone. 10 years, Marcus, an entire decade, I have dealt with that pitiful excuse of a man who clearly did not have any respect for my privacy. Every morning he would come to my house, sit on my chair like a bag of shit, and eat his porridge. That disgusting cold porridge, like a meal for a rolling bulbous hog. He would stand there, Marcus, and give me that blank stare, just watch me with his void expression. But I knew what he was trying to do, Marcus. Oh, I knew the extreme lengths he went to break my sanity. Good morning, Winston. How are you, Winston? I brought you this porridge, neighbor. Those insincere, evil remarks hidden under his false gestures of kindness. I know what you are doing, you vile boar. Why don't you try this porridge, Winston? So happy to see you, Winston. Good night, Winston. Hello there, Winston. Hello, Winston, 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 Winston! Dear Marcus, there is a trail of smoke rising from that old decrepit brick chimney. And in recent hours, it has taken the shape of a black serpent. It is rising from the mouth of the dead, watching me closely, detecting my every breath. But I can see him. I am watching him too. I go to the tree at the edge of the yard and I watch. Sometimes at nights, when I hope I won't be seen. But I must go closer. And now, at the dead hour of the night, amid the dreadful silence of that old house. So strange. He is there, Marcus. I don't know how, but he is in that house. He is getting closer. I feel him coming after me. His voice. That voice that won't leave me alone. I've put up Father's bear traps around the house and trip wires. I laid glass by the doorway and nailed the windows shut. But I am afraid nothing. Nothing keeps his trembling voice from reaching my soul. I can hear him, Marcus. I can hear him so perfectly. The sound of that beast. I found footsteps leading to me. Deep, violent marks scratching towards me from the endless white. He is here, Marcus. He is in the pictures, watching me. Everywhere, listening to every thought. Every word I put down.